In this tutorial, we will teach you how to correctly wire your DIRIS Digiware system, configure the entire system from the Easy Config System software, connect to WebVIEW-M to visualize measurements. Here's an electrical panel comprising a three-phase feed as well as several single-phase feeders. We will use a DIRIS Digiware power monitoring system comprising a DIRIS Digiware M70 communication gateway with embedded web server WebVIEW-M, a U30 voltage module, and three I35 current modules, one for the main incomer and two for the six outgoing circuits. I35 modules will be connected to TR split core current sensors. A set of cables will be used, RJ45 cables to connect modules together and RJ12 for the connection of modules to the TR current sensors. The panel is currently powered off and will remain so for the duration of the wiring. First, install the M70 gateway. Then the DIRIS Digiware U30 voltage module, which is unique to the system. Then each I35 current measurement module. Connect the 24 VDC power supply to the M70. Then an Ethernet cable to connect it to the network. Then connect the Digiware bus between the M70 gateway and the U30 voltage module. Then between each module in the system. Thanks to the RJ45 bus, wiring is quick and safe. Connect the end-of-line resistor to the last module in the system. Connect the voltage terminal to the U30 module. Finally, connect the TR current sensors to the I35 modules using the RJ12 cables. Once the system is wired, you can power it on. The on-LED of the M70 gateway and the modules is solid green. Start the auto-discovery of the modules connected to the Digiware bus by pressing the addressing button located below the M70 gateway for 2 seconds. The COM-LEDs of all the modules start flashing synchronously. After about 1 minute, the COM-LEDs of the I35 modules are fixed, which means there are address conflicts. This is normal since their factory default modbus address is the same. To resolve address conflicts, simply press the push button on the nose of the conflicting modules one after the other for approximately 2 seconds. The COM-LEDs of these I35 modules start flashing and the auto-discovery process is complete. Note that the order in which you press the push button will determine the addressing order of the modules. We will now proceed to the configuration of each module of the Digiware system. In this tutorial, we will show you how to do it from the Easy Config System software by connecting the M70 gateway to a PC via a USB cable. You can also do this while connected via Ethernet. Log in as administrator to access all the configuration features of the measurement system. The default password is admin. Create a new configuration, then name it. Enter this configuration, then connect in USB mode by clicking on USB mode at the top right of your screen. If the auto-discovery process has already been done, which is the case here, the modules that have been discovered will be listed below the M70 gateway. Click on the binoculars icon at the top left of the screen to access the visualization menus. Click on the M70 gateway. A dashboard gathers the main information of the M70, such as its IP configuration, active services, connected devices, etc. It is from this dashboard that you can launch the auto-discovery process. Performing the auto-discovery from Easy Config System allows you to modify the modbus address of the devices discovered. A blink button is located to the right of each device to make its on LED blink. Click on the wrench icon at the top left to access the device's configuration menus. Now set up each device in the measurement system, starting with the M70 gateway. The Auto Discovery menu allows you to modify the Auto Discovery mode, fast or full, to define an addressing range, or to choose the method for resolving address conflicts, automatic or by push button. Click on the IP configuration to configure the gateway's IP address. This will allow you to communicate remotely with the M70 and access the WebVIEW-M web server to visualize measurements. Other menus are also available to configure additional functions such as alarms, email notifications, other communication protocols, etc. When you make changes, a pencil appears next to the equipment, which means that modifications are awaiting to be sent to this equipment. A pencil also appears next to the menus that have been modified. Proceed to the configuration of the U30 voltage module. Click on Electrical Network to configure a three-phase network, a nominal frequency of 50 Hz and nominal voltage of 400 volts. Other menus are also available to configure additional functions such as integration periods, the creation of alarms, etc. Now configure the first I35 module, which measures the main incomer. Go to the Load menu, name it, and configure a 3-phase plus neutral load with 3 CTs with a nominal current of 63 amps. Loads 2 and 3 are disabled on this I35 module. Then go to the Current Sensor menu. You can see that the rating of the 3 TR10 sensors are automatically detected. Check the settings, such as orientation and associated voltage. The Program button, present on each configuration menu at the top right of your screen, allows you to send the configuration, but only for the menu you're currently on. After clicking on Program, you can see that the pencil on the right of the Current Sensors menu disappears. Now proceed to the configuration of the second I35 current module, which measures 3 single-phase loads. Click on the Loads menu, and this time configure 3 single-phase loads. You can name each load as you wish, and change the nominal current to optimize the scale of the graphics on the D70 and WebView. And finally, configure the third current module I35, also with 3 single-phase loads. Changes have been made to all the devices, but those changes have not been sent yet. Go to the Multi-Device Configuration menu. It allows you to select several devices and to send the configuration to all devices simultaneously. Return to the configuration menu. Notice that the pencils are gone. Now go to the visualization menu. The dashboard of the I35 modules gathers system information, firmware version, serial number, date and time, detected current sensors and their ratings, ongoing system alarms, and a phase diagram to identify potential wiring or configuration errors. you also have access to all real-time measurements in a table format. In the Topology menu, you can save the configuration of a device and apply it to other identical devices. This can save you time if several devices have identical or similar configurations. Saved configurations are listed in the Templates Management menu. You can save them on your computer, and you can also upload existing configurations from your computer. Here you go, your DIRIS Digiware system is now configured. Connect to WebVIEW-M by typing the IP address of the M70 in your browser's address bar. Log in as administrator with the default password admin. For cybersecurity reasons, the application asks you to change the default password that has just expired. This password must be changed at least once a year. An alarm will be triggered 15 days before the password expires to remind you. Once connected as admin, click on the wrench icon in the top left corner, then click on Devices. Click on Modify Active Configuration, then Sources. From the Data Source tab, click on the Scan button to add products present in the D70 display's topology. Once products are added, you can change their names and turn area to sort them by location. The plus button allows you to add products manually to the topology, whether they are locally connected to the M70 via the Digiware or RS485 bus or remote via Ethernet. In the Circuits tab, you can check loads are correctly configured and named. Naming was done from Easy Config System, but you can also do it or change the names from WebView. Go to the Hierarchies tab. Click on Add a Hierarchy, choose a name and fluid and validate. The modules and associated loads are listed in the left pane. All you need to do is drag and drop the loads on the central screen. Here, a main incomer split in several circuits. Once finished, save the hierarchy. At last, go to the Photoviews tab. This menu allows you to upload a picture and to place elements such as real-time measurements, alarms, or text directly on the picture to get a custom overview of your electrical installation. Create a new Photoview named Demo Panel, for example. Choose an icon, upload a picture of your choice from your laptop, and validate. You can now drag and drop elements of your choice, such as measurements, directly on the picture by choosing the device and the measurement parameter. Repeat the same operation with other devices or measurement parameters and click on the floppy disk to save your photo view. You can also create additional photo views if necessary. Here, for instance, you can create a second photo view displaying the single line diagram of the same demo panel. Here you go. You can now go back to the home screen and enjoy the different visualization menus to visualize and analyze your measurement and consumption data. In this tutorial video, we showed you how to set up your DIRIS Digiware power monitoring system directly from the D70 display, and how to configure the web server to be able to visualize and analyze data remotely on WebVIEW-M.